Hello and welcome to the next VBScript video. In this video, we look at how to work with databases using VBScript. Now, as the diagram shows, we have the script written in VBScript, and basically the script can connect to any kind of data source. So this data source can be a database or it can be another data source like an Excel file, an XML file, a CSV file, or any other data source. Now there are COM objects available, and in VBScript we can create instances of those COM objects and work with the data source or the database. The important COM objects that we can use in VBScript are the ADO objects. It stands for ActiveX Data Objects, and two of the powerful ADO objects are the Connection and the RecordSet. Now, what is a connection? A connection is basically an object that connects the script to the database. Now, if the connection is open, that time we can execute commands on the database. And also, if the connection is open, we can fetch data from the database. Now, connection is the fundamental object. And in addition to the connection, we can have the record set object. Basically, the record set object is a copy of the result set that we can get from the database. So let us say that we execute an SQL query on the database, which is something like select star from table name. So that produces a result set consisting of many columns and many rows. A record set is a copy of that result set, and we can look at it in VBScript and we can use it to show values on the screen in the GUI or the command line. And also there are other operations we can perform with it. So let us see an example of how we can use VBScript to connect to the database and execute commands on the database. Now here is a VBScript that we have, but before we see the VBScript, I'm going to work with SQL Server SQL Express, and here I have a database. The name of the database is Test Company, and it contains a number of sample tables. One of the tables is customers, and if we execute the SQL query select star from customers, it shows us that there are three records in this table. And the names of the customers are Cust1, Cust2, and Cust3. Now, let us see how we can get that information using VBScript. So, here is the VBScript, and we have a couple of variables, OBJ connection to store the reference to the connection, and OBJ record set to contain the reference to the record set. Now, the first sub procedure that we call is open ADO objects. And this is the sub procedure. Now here what we do is we use a create object built in VBScript function to create adodb.connection. Then we call the open method on the connection and pass it a connection string. The connection string is basically a string which specifies that what is the kind of the database, whether it is SQL Server or any other kind of DBMS. What is the name of the server and other details like username and password. Then we set a reference to the OBJ record set and create adodb.recordset object. Now this is the important line. We call the open method on the OBJ record set object, and here we have to specify the SQL query. So here our SQL query is select star from customers, which means return all the records in the customers table. And this statement is executed on OBJ connection, and we have to give couple of more arguments. The first argument is basically defining the type of the record set. So this means AD open key set. Basically, we can perform several operations when the record set is the open key set type. And the argument of 3 means add lock optimistic, basically what kind of lock we want to place. So right now let us not worry about the value of these two arguments. but understand that once the record set is open, it will contain all the rows from the customer's table. Whether the customer table contains one row or 10 rows or 100 rows, whatever is the number of rows, a copy of the entire customer's table will be available in OBJ record set object. Now the next sub procedure that we call is show customers. Now in the show customers sub procedure, we use a with statement, so we don't have to repeat OBJ record set again and again. Now here is a do while loop. So when the record set is open, at that time the record set has a pointer. The pointer points to any particular record within the record set. So at the beginning, the pointer is going to point to the first record in the record set. That means the first customer. Now here is the entire record set. So at the beginning, the pointer is going to point to the customer ID of 1. Now what we do is we say wscript.echo and we get the name value from that record and has their office address at, and then we get the billing address value. And within the do while loop, we write a MoveNext method. Now MoveNext simply moves the record pointer to the next record. So basically what is going to happen is it will start at the first record, display the value, then go to the next record, again display the value, and keep on doing that until it is at end of file. And when it is at end of file, not end of file condition becomes false and it comes out of the loop. So let us execute this and see how it works. So we are going to use the wscript command, wscript dbscript.vbs, and here we can see that it says cust ID has their office address at cust1 address, cust2 has their office address at cust2 bill address, cust3 has their office address at cust3 billing address, and this is exactly the same data that we see over here, cust1, cust2 and cust3. So that is about how we can get the data from database and display it in our VBScript or use it in our VBScript. Now let us see how we can add new data to the database. So for that we have the add temp customer sub procedure. Now what add temp customer sub procedure does is it basically adds a dummy record. So right now we can see that there are three records in the customers table, basically for three customers. So what we do is we call the add new method on the OBJ record set. So basically it adds one more record to the record set, and we can set each of the fields. So here we can see the fields are customer ID, name, bill address and ship address. So here we have given some value of customer ID, name, bill address and ship address. So let us execute this script and see how this works. So the script is now executed. Now if we execute this SQL statement again, basically look at all the rows in the customers table. So what we find is a new record has been inserted into the table. So whatever values we gave of customer ID, name, bill address and ship address, so those values have come over here. Now what we can also do is we can update the existing data. Now so far what we have seen is that we have been manipulating the record set. We used a copy of the result set of the SQL statement in our record set, and we were able to display it in our VBScript, and also we were able to add new records to the record set. Now let us say that we have to update some existing data. Now one way to update existing data is to find out that particular record in the record set and update it. There is another way of doing it, and that is using a SQL statement to directly execute on the connection object. So here we have the connection object and we say dot execute and we write the update statement. So here the statement is update customers set name is equal to customer 1 where name is equal to cust 1. So right now if we execute this SQL statement, we see that the names of the four customers in the four rows are cust1, cust2, cust3 and cust4. But what we want to do now is we want to find out which row has the name as cust1. So basically it is the first record which has the name as cust1. So there we want to put the name as customer1. Right now it is cust1. So let us execute this script now and go to our database and look at the contents of the customers table. So here we can see that instead of cust1 we got customer1. So here the difference is that instead of working on the record set object, we directly worked with the connection object. So that is how we can update the data. So let us say we don't want to update the data, but we just want to delete the temporary record that we created in the customers table. So basically where we put the customer ID as 4 and name as cust4. So here also we can directly execute a command on the connection object. So basically the command is delete customers where customer ID is 4. So whenever you are issuing the delete command, it is very important to put the exact where clause, because if you don't put the where clause, delete command will delete all the records in that table. So be extra careful with the delete command. So what we want to do is we want to find out all the rows in the customers table where customer ID is 4, and basically there is one record where customer ID is 4, and delete that particular record from the customers table. So here we see that the customer ID is 4 in just this record, and this is what we want to delete. So let us execute this script once again, and the script is successfully executed. Let us go back to the database and execute the select star from customers again, and we see that where customer ID was 4, that record has been deleted now. So this is how we can work with databases. As VBScript is capable of connecting to many different kinds of data sources, it can be an Excel file or a CSV file or Microsoft Access database, or it can be a SQL Server, Oracle, any kind of relational database. And we can work with ADO COM objects. So basically we can work with the connection object or the record set object. When we want to display some data to the user or perform some manipulations on the data of a result set, we can use the record set object. If we just have to execute some simple commands, then we can use the connection object. So that is all for this video, and see you in the next videos. Thank you.